Hi guys, this is Alex from FightStoreProducts.com, and in the last little video on our heavy bag series, I'm going to come to the Old Faithful, the very first bag that anybody, in my opinion, should be buying if they're boxing. If you're kickboxing, you'd maybe buy the 6-foot version, but we'll talk about that later. So, we've got the Revgear 4-foot bag here. Now, the brand, as I've said in previous videos, doesn't really matter, but I am going to talk about construction material for a second here. These ones here are made of 22-ounce vinyl, constructed in the USA, which is very, very, very unusual, but I know that that's all to do with the quality of the construction. It uses very, very heavy quality, heavy-duty strapping, heavy quality D-rings at the top. I don't know if you can see here, but the amount of stitching here between the straps and the outer ring is very heavy. You can't see the zip, thankfully, but it's uber strong. Leather is not necessarily a superior quality material when constructing heavy bags. This is a misnomer. In fact, if you're in a hot country like this, where, you know, during the summer it's going to get very, very humid, then the one thing about leather is it's an organic material and it can rot, so that when it gets wet and humid and then dries out, wet and humid, dries out, wet and humid, dries out, then it starts to crack. Now, 22-ounce vinyl doesn't do that. So, when you're thinking about buying a bag, don't necessarily equate leather with quality. You can get very, very cheap leather bags, and you can get very, very expensive leather bags. You can get very, very cheap PU bags, and get very, very expensive vinyl bags. This is vinyl. Sandy make a good one. Fairtex make a good one. ProBox make great bags. Ringside are making some bags now. I believe they're pretty good too. I haven't actually tried one, so it's difficult for me to say from this video. This one's a great bag. I would go generally for about a 40 kilo bag on a boxing punch bag like this. You don't need it that much heavier, but certainly don't want it too much lighter. I think 30 is probably too light. 35, 40, 45, all good. So this is just an all-around bag. They swing slow. We can use it for a variety of drills, you can use it for a workout, yeah, they're going to move around a little, but not too much if you get the right weight bag. When you hit a bag, you want it to jump, you don't want it to swing. Anybody can swing a bag, well, that's no energy at all, but this should be the first bag you buy. If you're not kickboxing, if you're kickboxing, you might want to look at the 6-foot bag, but certainly for a boxing gym or anything hands, 4-foot bag is the starting point for any gym. Until next time, see you later. There's a round.